If you couldn't tell by my nails, it's spooky season, which means it's time for a spooky shell challenge. So here we have Sarah Spooky Shell, hashtag Sarah Spooky Shell on the gallery. If you want to grab it and download it, turn it into whatever you want. It doesn't have to be spooky, but I turned it into an abandoned factory turned witch's lair. I don't know. The vision for it kind of morphed while we were building it, but that's fine. It's a very weird shell. Like, it has a basement. It has a big like courtyard moment area. As you can see, I toyed around with the idea of a second floor, but like I really wanted the courtyard to be like a courtyard but that was like open to the top, and I was like, if we do a second floor, how am I gonna work around that? I'm not that creative, you know, all that stuff. So we just did a basement, but you can rotate the basement and the top floor separately. I don't really care if you change it, because I wasn't building the basement in thinking like, oh, you should be able to put stairs in this, so I'm gonna build the basement that way. Like, I wasn't thinking about it at all. So if you need to move the basement, don't worry. We probably already just went past it, but I did try to roof this and then I gave up. I always try to roof my shell challenges to show you all that like it is possible. You can roof it. This one, I don't know. I think if you want to put a roof over the courtyard, that's fine. Like, that's allowed. So that might make it easier, but I didn't want to do that. So I didn't put a roof over the courtyard. You know how it goes. Actually, probably what you're seeing right now shows the courtyard covered up, but I changed it. I think I actually probably cut out that part. This speed build kind of does jump around a little bit, just because I built this over 2 or 3 streams, I think. And also I did forget to screen record one part of it that I was streaming, but I will talk about that when we get there. But yeah, so I went with this sort of industrial vibe. I probably used more Batuu in this than I've ever used in any build, which is like, you know, but those windows that I just put in the kitchen, I really, really like those. And we also end up with like a table from Batuu. We use some Batuu like clutter items, I think. You know, it all kind of works out, I have to say. But yeah, so this is what this shell is all about. Tours will be on October 31st. They're going to be on Halloween. Usually I do 2 days of tours, but I'm just gonna do 1 day of tours, and we're gonna have like a Halloween party extravaganza. It's gonna be so much fun. And we also are going to be raising money for Able Gamers as part of a charity event on that day. So make sure you come and hang out. You don't have to contribute monetarily to contribute to the stream. Think of it as like, even you being there like makes the numbers higher. It makes Twitch boost the stream more, and you may help boost the stream to someone who may monetarily contribute. So like, even indirectly, you're helping the charity by just hanging out. So make sure you're following me over on there. I know a lot of you already do. That will be in a week and a few days. We're gonna do a ton of fun like charity incentives. I'm gonna try and find some like mini costumes that I can like change out as an incentive. We do this really fun voice mod thing when we do charity streams that I'm excited to bring back. All stuff like that. And it's gonna be really fun. And as always, I say as always as if this has only happened one time before, but there will be a winner of the shell challenge, or 1 or 2 winners. There were 2 winners last time, and all you get is a special role in the Discord. I hope eventually to be able to afford to give all the winners stuff packs and stuff, but as of right now, you just get a role in the Discord and bragging rights, honestly. So like I said, the idea for this shell kind of morphed a few times. I was originally going to try and make it like super witchy, like witch's lair 100%, but then we kind of shifted away from that, and it's more of just like homey vibes, but like it's clear that witches live here. And it's a little quirky, but I was able to fit 2 bedrooms. Like, I was not sure if I was gonna be able to fit 2 bedrooms. You honestly probably could fit 2 or 3 if you really tried, because I also have like an open common space in the basement by the bedrooms. So if you wanted to sort of readjust all of that, I think you definitely could fit 3 bedrooms. That's not really a challenge, but like, I think you could. My original idea for the pond in the back was like industrial waste, acid mine drainage, like, you know, oh, it's turned the plant life into these alien things, because we did use a lot of the plants from Get to Work and stuff, and I think a little bit of Strangerville to get that look. But then we started thinking of it as like the witches discard their failed potions into the pond, and that is what has turned all the plant life. So it looks really cool at night. We will take a look at it in the game, don't worry. And there's also a little like, it's not a closed off office study area. You'll probably see that in just a little bit. Like, it has bookshelves, and I imagine there are all the potion recipe books and stuff like that. And then I think we used the flower arranging table, and then added some crystals and potion bottles and beakers and stuff to make it look like it is where they craft the potions. So I really like that. And the courtyard, we did a cauldron area, of course, and there's a little sitting area there, dining area, whatever. I didn't know where else we'd be able to fit a dining area, just because courtyard, it just makes everything so weird. It is a weird shell, but it doesn't have any diagonals, so consider consider that I did give you no diagonals. It's just a weird looking shell. But yeah, I hope everyone's been having a good week. I don't think I've uploaded since last week. I've been trying, you know, I try with the YouTube shorts just to throw stuff out there and see what sticks. But I do actually have quite a few videos pre-recorded, but I just haven't gotten around to editing them. I went to my friend's wedding last weekend. I've been pretty busy. I'm busy again this weekend. I'm busy again next weekend, but don't worry. I have a lot of videos planned. I think I have three that I haven't edited that are waiting to be edited and uploaded. So you do have stuff to look forward to. One of them is a new episode of Sarah Builds the States. One of them is a CC review, and one of them is trying out a demo for a new home building game that I think is supposed to officially come out in January. Don't know if the demo is still available, but I'll talk about that more in that video, but that is something you can look forward to. And of course, all my TikToks. We love having fun over on TikTok. I've been doing random dimensions for every room in my Sims build. Someone suggested I do that in my comment section, so I've been starting to do that. And the house we have is just so funny. It has like a giant dining room, a teeny tiny living room. It's really a lot of fun. I'm having so much fun with that challenge. I probably will do it as a YouTube video pretty soon. Oh, I forgot there is another speed build that I have. We built this like cozy fall home on stream with CC, because that's the thing, I never use CC. So it was like this big thing, like, oh my gosh, I'm using CC in this build. But there's so much good CC out there, especially a lot of stuff that just came out too. And you'll see it as I'll talk about it in the CC review video. But we made this just like really cute house. Like, I'm so obsessed with it. And unfortunately, the speed build will probably not be out until like November, but that's something for you to stick around for, right? I didn't really do it based on a real life floor plan. I kind of did, but I based it off a real life exterior. So like by proxy, we kind of did it the same floor plan, but like not really, I don't know. But it was really frustrating because of like proportions in The Sims. Like even with CC, I couldn't get exactly what I wanted. And that's because of like the proportions in the game that were being so upsetting to me. I don't know. That's just how it goes. I don't know. But today is Thursday. I don't know if I'm gonna be uploading this on Thursday or Friday. We'll see how fast I can edit this. But I'm gonna be honest, I'm having so much trouble with this talk over, this face cam over, this voice over, whatever you call it. I keep having to pause, like collect my thoughts. Like I don't even know what I'm saying. So if this seems a little jumbled and all over the place, I'm sorry. I'm a human with faults like all of you. But yeah, I really wanted to have this video out so that you know that there's a shell challenge going on. Like if this were any other video, I'd wait till tomorrow to film it just because I'm not feeling it today. But I need you all to know that we have a shell challenge. So here's your announcement. We have a shell challenge going on. I love shell challenges. I love seeing what everyone comes up with. Like shell challenge tour streams are literally my favorite streams because everyone is so creative. Like I'll be like, ooh, I'm so creative. I thought of a industrial factory turned witch's lair, like haha. And then someone would be like, I thought of something 10 times cooler than that. And I'm like, so true. You did, and you deserve all the praise and recognition. Like I love seeing what everyone comes up with. Also, like it's such an honor, I guess. Is that the right word? I don't know. It's like so fun for me to like, I don't know, just like know that you guys like put so much time and effort into all of this. Like it makes me so happy. Like, oh my gosh. And I know like you do any kind of shell challenge, not specifically my shell challenge, but like to know that people put so much time and effort makes me so happy. I don't know. But the idea for these bedrooms, it was kind of like an older witch and a younger witch that she mentors, like a teenage witch, but not Sabrina the Teenage Witch. But like if you're gonna think of a teenage witch, of course you're gonna think of Sabrina the Teenage Witch. Speaking of, I've never watched Chilling Adventures of Sabrina, and I really forgot it existed until I said something about Sabrina the Teenage Witch while I was building this house, and someone was like, oh yeah, like the reboot or whatever they call it, like the new version of it. And I'm like what? And then I remembered, I was like, wait, that's so true, they did that, oh my gosh. But something I love, I have to give a massive shout out to Twisted Mexi for not only Tool but for Better Build By, because in this teen room I was like, we need something to like change up the vibe, like we really just need the vibe to be changed up. And Better Build By lets you change the like hue of the light in build mode, which I don't know why we don't have that in The Sims. If you watched the Animal Crossing Direct last week, they literally showed that we'll be able to change the light color in build mode in Animal Crossing, and I'm like, why can we not do that in The Sims? Like that seems like a really easy fix, like a really easy patch. I don't know, because there are some things that like fundamentally don't make sense in the game, like putting walls on half tiles, putting platforms on half tiles. Someone please tell TikTok you can't put platforms on half tiles. I talked about Stairgate last time. Stairgate is still ongoing. I just beefed with someone in my comments about it because they were like, you can do it with cheats, laughing face, laughing face, laughing face, like laughing at me because they thought I didn't know. And maybe my response was a little snarky. I since deleted everything, but I was like, I literally play The Sims for a living. I think I would know if a cheat could fix it. And they were like, oh my God, you don't have to be a B word. And I was like, you were being mean. You added emojis to be rude. And they were like, oh, all emojis are rude, I guess. And I was like, ah. And I literally said, I'm not gonna argue with someone who's so clearly 13 years old. Because like, literally, why would you take me being like, it was rude that you added those emojis? Not me ranting again. But me saying it was rude that you added those emojis and then being like, oh, all emojis are rude. Got it. Like, use your brain. I'm so sorry. I promise I don't just use my other platforms to complain about my TikTok comments, but that's obviously where I get the most comments. So obviously it's where I get the most mean things. I don't even know. Once I said I wasn't gonna argue with someone who's so clearly 13, they're like, you were obviously looking for an argument when you responded so rudely. And I was like, whatever, whatever. So I need someone to make me like one of those affirmation things. It's like, I will not. I need it to be, I will not respond to mean comments on TikTok. I have a right to respond to them because they're being mean to me. But my general rule of thumb is that I will be nice to people until they show that they have no intent to be nice to me. And that is what so many TikTok comments prove, is that they don't want to be nice to me. And that is when I say, okay, I'll be a little sassy back. I'll try, maybe. But anyway, that's my general rule of thumb. Like, I think it's a simple rule. It's a simple concept. But anyway, here I am working on this back pond. It's like, this was so frustrating. I was using the tool mod and I basically was trying to place these light strips on the like stilt foundation of the home. And it wasn't gonna let me place them in there regularly because they can't intersect with water, which I think doesn't make sense. So I tried all this stuff. I tried to place them fine, and then I tried to fill it up with water again, and then they disappeared. It took me so long to place them. And then I filled it up with water, and then they disappeared. It was so sad. So that was the part that we accidentally cut out. I accidentally forgot to screen record the placing of the plants and the like sitting area, the little common space in the basement. That just gives you something to stick around to the end for. And I honestly could be like, oh, I cut it out because it was too long. But no, I will admit to my mistakes. I forgot to screen record. And I didn't think it was worth it to like delete that stuff and then go back acting like I was building it again for the first time. But yeah, this front porch area turned out really cute. I just was trying to find like random stuff in debug. I didn't even really know what I was doing. But I did realize that like landscaping stuff doesn't work with the tool mod. Like you can't rotate it. You can size it down and do everything else, but like rotating it doesn't work. And I don't know if that's just I need an updated version or what. Anyway, put some like random crates, some random like industrial, what do you call those, silos? Like I don't even know. I just like said, let's put some of that stuff in there. And I think my favorite feature in this build that like really brings in that like old industrial factory vibe is the, what do you call them, pipes that go from the floor to the ceiling. And I ended up using a little bit of the industrial loft kit lights. They just kind of brought the vibe as well. And I felt that was really fitting. Yeah, feel free to turn this into literally whatever you want. You can turn it into a community lot if you want. Imagine if you turned it into a haunted house. I feel like someone told me that they turned it into a haunted house. I try not to like take a look obviously before tours, but I feel like sometimes I get comments like on TikTok because I post about it on TikTok, or people in my Twitch chat are saying, oh, I turned it into this. Oh, I turned it into this. So I feel like someone did turn it into a haunted house, and I've always wanted to build a haunted. I don't think I've ever built a haunted house in The Sims. No, that's a lie. I built that one when the paranormal stuff came out, but it wasn't like specifically a haunted house. Like I'm talking like haunted house, like as an event, as an attraction, like the kind of haunted house that you would go to as an outing for Halloween to be scared, not just a house that is haunted. Yeah, just was finishing up with a little bit of landscaping, you know, here and there. I didn't actually do much landscaping. Honestly, the terrain manipulation was too much for me. Like I lifted it up onto a little tiny, tiny hill and I said, that's it. I cannot do any more landscaping. That's all we're getting. I'm so sorry. But yeah, I did a little bit more decor and stuff on the back porch. It looks so cool at night. We need to jump into the game and take a look. So here is what the shell looks like. These are the base walls and everything. And here is what I have done with it. The camera is kind of freaking out right now, but this is what it looks like. And here it is, very unassuming at night until you get back here. I just love how everything glows. It's so cool. It's so cool. But here's what it looks like when you walk in. You are immediately greeted by the skeleton, of course. This is the kitchen area and everything. Over here is shoe racks, coat racks, witch's brooms, all of this. Then there's a little dining area, a little living area. And then here is like the potion crafter station. I thought the mask would be a good touch. I don't know. So then you come downstairs and it's very unassuming. It just looks like a little shrine to the bug light. We love the bug light. But we had to have a bookcase door into just this little sitting gathering area. The fireplace, it's honestly very cozy. I really like it. And then this is one of the bedrooms. I really liked the vintage glamour wallpaper for this. And then this is the bathroom. Again, not too crazy. And here is the teenage witch room. I love it. I just love how pink it is. It's so fun. And then here is the backyard, back porch area. Very fun. Just don't fall off. I did not feel like putting a fence. And here it all is at night. So yeah, I think that's gonna wrap it up here. Make sure you're subscribed and that you like this video if you had a good time. Tours for the shell will be October 31st. It's a Sunday at 12 p.m. Eastern. Make sure you are following on Twitch if you are not already. And of course, make sure you're following on TikTok and all of that fun stuff. All the links will be down below. And other than that, I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day and a lovely tomorrow. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I will see you in my next one. Bye!